newly unveiled fossil over 100 million years old appears to show a weasel-like mammal locked in mortal combat with a dinosaur three times its size.
It's a pretty amazing thing to look at. It's the first example that I know of preserving a mammal and a dinosaur engaging in that way.
This is not like, you know, the Mesozoic equivalent of a bunny rabbit or a squirrel. This is the Mesozoic equivalent of like a Tasmanian devil. If anything could take out a dinosaur bigger than it, this species could.
This new evidence suggests that mammals and dinosaurs may have had a much more complex predator-prey relationship than previously thought, challenging conventional notions of dinosaur dominance over mammals.
One of the questions that comes up is, what was this mammal thinking?
Typically, predators attack animals their own size or smaller, but it's not unprecedented for mammals to go after larger animals, even today. The study authors are convinced that in this case, the mammal attacked the dinosaur while it was alive.
The fact that the hind foot of the mammal is actually trapped beneath the folded hind leg of the dinosaur, it looks for all the world like the dinosaur collapsed on top of the mammal, trapping its hind foot. And that we don't think could happen if the dinosaur was already dead.
Still, Longrich isn't ruling out the possibility that the mammal was scavenging on an already dead dinosaur.
I think scavenging, I find a plausible explanation. Look, these animals have been dead for 125 million years. What's going on there? We have limited evidence. It seems like if you're fighting a struggling dinosaur, you don't want to stick your hand in his mouth. So is it scavenging? Is it predation? I think both are possible. It's very hard to say definitively. It's a bit of a mystery.
The two animals were likely frozen in time and impeccably preserved by a volcanic mudslide in what is now northeastern China, where the fossil was found. The fossil is a rare look at a complete skeleton of a dinosaur and a near complete skeleton of the mammal.
It's pretty rare to find something that's like nose to tail or nose to most of the tail complete is pretty exceptional.
But unfortunately, fossil forgeries are not uncommon. So researchers took measures, including analyzing sediment in the fossil and from where it was found to verify its authenticity.
Most of the fossil forgeries to come out of China are fairly simple juxtapositions of, you know, one animal maybe next to another, or one fossil next to another, or one on top of the other. In the case of our fossil, the two skeletons are well intertwined, so we feel pretty confident that in our findings.
It seems if I was a fossil collector over there and I dug up a complete dinosaur like that, I'd probably just sell it. I wouldn't wait until I found a mammal and then glue it on top. It's like I just won the lottery with this complete dinosaur, and like you wouldn't say, okay, let's hold on, let's see if you can win the lottery again and get a complete mammal I can stick on top of it.
Still, there is limited evidence of mammal-dinosaur interactions in the fossil record, and researchers say more is needed before drawing definitive conclusions.
I think this is something we're going to be arguing about for a while. It might not be the last paper. That's how science advances, one argument at a time.